Dear students, welcome to my classroom. In previous part of the chapter pair of linear equations in two variables, we completed some problems in exercise 4.1 and we are in second problem. In second problem, it is given that some pairs of linear equations are given and asked to check whether they are consistent or inconsistent, and also asked to solve them graphically. In this section, we completed four problems up to that bit D. Let us solve the fifth one. The fifth one is 4/3x plus 2y is equal to 8. 2x plus 3y is equal to 2. Okay, so we have to check whether these two equations are consistent or not, and also we have to solve them graphically. Okay, let's write these two equations in standard form. So the first equation is 4/3x plus 2y is equal to 8. So we can take 3 as LCM. So we can write this 4/3x plus 2y equal to 8 as 4x plus 6y by 3. 3 is the LCM. So 3 to the 6, so 6 into y, 6y. So 4x plus 6y by 3 is equal to 8. And again, it can be written as 4x plus 6y is equal to 8, 3 is a 24. So the first equation can be written as 4x plus 6y minus 24 equal to 0. And the second equation is 2x plus 3y minus 12 is equal to 0. Okay. Take them as equation 1 and equation 2. So by comparing these two equations with standard form, a1x plus b1y plus c1 equal to 0 and a2x plus b2y plus c2 equal to 0, we have a1, which is the coefficient of x in first equation, is 4, and b1 is the coefficient of y equal to 6, and c1 is the constant and is equal to minus 24. A1 is equal to 4, B1 is equal to 6, and C1 is equal to minus 24. And A2, B2, C2 are the coefficients in second equation. That is A2 equal to 2, B2 equal to 3, and C2 equal to minus 12. So let us check whether they are consistent or inconsistent. For that, we compare the ratio of corresponding coefficients. So take first the ratio of x coefficients, that is A1 by A2. And a1 by a2 is equal to 4/2, which is equal to 2. And now take b1 by b2. So b1 by b2 is 6/3, again equal to 2. Take c1 by c2. c1 by c2 is equal to minus 24 by minus 12, and is equal to 2. So here you can observe that all the ratios a1 by a2, b1 by b2, and c1 by c2 are equal. Okay, so let us write a1 by a2 equal to b1 by b2 equal to c1 by c2. Whenever a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2, we need not to find the value of c1 by c2. But here a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2, so that we have to find the value of c1 by c2 also. So here c1 by c2 is also equal to both a1 by a2 and b1 by b2. So in this case, we know that the given two equations are inconsistent. Okay, because here, the given two equations are consistent, because the lines represented by given equations are coincident. When they are coincident, every point on the line is a solution of the given equations. So that's why the given equations are consistent. So now, let us solve the equations graphically. So for equation 1, let us write the table with values x and y, where the point x and y is lies on the line represented by equation 1. So here the first equation is 4x plus 6y minus 24 equal to 0. From that we can write 6y is equal to 24 minus 4x. and that implies we have y is equal to 24 minus 4x by 6. So let us draw the table for equation 1. So in the first column we have x, and in second column we need to find the values of y using y is equal to 24 minus 4x by 6, and in third column we are writing the points x and y. So take any two values for x. So first take x equal to 0. If x equal to 0, then y equal to 24 minus 0, that is 24 by 6, which is equal to 4. So the point x comma y is 0 comma 4. And if x equal to 3, then y is equal to 24 minus 4 is 12. 24 minus 12 is 12. 12 by 6 is 2. So the point is 3 comma 2. So similarly, for equation 2, what is equation 2? 2x plus 3y minus 12 equal 0. From this we can write 3y is equal to 12 minus 2x, and from that we can write y is equal to 12 minus 2x by 3. So draw the table and take any two values for x. Here I am taking x equal to minus 3. If x equal to minus 3, then y equal to 12 minus 2 into minus 3 is minus, so plus 6. And 12 plus 6 is 18. 18 by 3 is 6. So the point is minus 3 comma 6. And similarly, if you take x equal to 6, then y equal to 12 minus 2, 6 are 12. It's 0. 0 by 3 is 0. So the point is 6 comma 0. Now the points on the line represented by equation 1 are 0 comma 4 and 3 comma 2, and the points lies on the line represented by equation 2 are minus 3 comma 6 and 6 comma 0. Now let us draw the graph for these two lines. Now take the graph paper and draw x-axis, y-axis, and also denote the units on both the axes and write the scale. On x-axis we have taken 1 centimeter equal to 1 unit, as well as on y-axis also we have taken 1 centimeter equal to 1 unit. And now let us draw the line represented by first equation. The points on the line represented by first equation are 0 comma 4 and 3 comma 2. So first plot the point 0 comma 4. So here we have 0 comma 4 on y-axis at 4, and 3 comma 2. So 3 comma 2, here it is we have. Now draw the line through these two points. This is the line 4x plus 6y minus 24 equal 0, which is the first equation. And now plot the points which lies on the line represented by equation 2. So the first one we have is minus 3 comma 6. So take minus 3 comma 6. So minus 3 comma 6 at the top we have. Observe carefully, watch carefully. Here we have minus 3 comma 6 and 6 comma 0. So 6 comma 0 is on x axis. So now let us join these two points. So the yellow line is the line represented by equation 2x plus 3y minus 12 equal 0. So here you can observe that these two lines are coincident. Okay. So as the two lines are coincident, a given equation has infinitely many solutions. And what are the solutions? Every point on the lines is a solution of given equations. Okay. So let's take the next problem, F. So first one, x plus y equal to 5, and second equation is 2x plus 2y equal to 10. So let us write the given equations in standard form. So first one is x plus y minus 5 equal 0, and second one is 2x plus 2y minus 10 equal 0. Take them as equations 1 and equation 2, and let us write the coefficients. That is a1, b1, c1, and a2, b2, c2. a1 equal to 1, b1 equal to 1, c1 is equal to minus 5, where a1, b1, c1 are the coefficients in equation 1, and similarly in equation 2 the coefficients are a2 equal to 2, b2 equal to 2, c2 equal to minus 10. And let us find the ratio of corresponding coefficients. So first take a1 by a2. So here we have a1 by a2 equal to 1 by 2 and b1 by b2. So b1 equal to 1, b2 equal to 2. So that b1 by b2 is also equal to 1 by 2. Whenever a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2, we need to go for c1 by c2. So take c1 by c2. C1 by c2 is equal to minus 5 by minus 10, which is equal to 1 by 2. So here we can observe that all the ratios a1 by a2, b1 by b2 and c1 by c2 are equal. So the given equations are consistent. Now let us draw the lines for given equations. So for equation 1, draw the table. What is equation 1? X plus y equal to 5, and from that we can write y is equal to 5 minus x. So let us draw the table. X, y is equal to 5 minus x and the point x comma y. Now take any two values for x. If x equal to 1, then y is equal to 5 minus 1, which is equal to 4. The point is 1 comma 4. And if x equal to 2, 3, then y is equal to 5 minus 3, which is equal to 2. So the point is 3 comma 2. Now draw the table for equation 2. In equation 2 we have 2x plus 2y minus 10 equals 0, and from that we can write that 2y is equal to 10 minus 2x, and from that we can write y is equal to 10 minus 2x by 2. Now draw the table for y is equal to 10 minus 2x by 2. So take any value for x. I'm taking 2, then y is equal to 10 minus 2 to the 4, 10 minus 4, 6 by 2 is 3, so point is 2 comma 3. And again, if you substitute x equal to 4, then y is equal to 10 minus 2, 4 is 8, 10 minus 8 is 2, 2 by 2 is 1, so y equal to 1, so the point is 4 comma 1. Now the points on the line represented by equation 1 are 1 comma 4 and 3 comma 2, and similarly the points on the line represented by equation 2 are 2 comma 3 and 4 comma 1. And let us draw the lines for these two equations. Now take the graph paper, y axis, y axis, and denote the units, write the scale and plot the points on the line 1. So first one is 1 comma 4 and next one is 3 comma 2, and draw the line through these points, and let's draw the line 2. So first point is 2 comma 3 and second point is 4 comma 1. So these two are lies on the line 1. So the line joining is again coincide with the line represented by equation 1. So here two lines are coincident. So given equations has infinitely many solutions. So every point on the lines is a solution of given equations. Okay, now take the next one. X minus y is equal to 8, 3x minus 3y is equal to 16. So write the given equations in standard form and also write the coefficients. Let us check a1 by a2 is equal to 1 by 3, b1 by b2 is also equal to 1 by 3, c1 by c2 is equal to 1 by 2, and we can observe that a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 but not is equal to c1 by c2. So the given lines are inconsistent. So let's draw the table for equation 1. From equation 1 we have y is equal to 8 minus x, x minus 8. So find the points on the line 1. If you take x equal to 4, then y equal to minus 4, If you take x equal to 5, then y is equal to minus 3. Point is 5 comma minus 3. And similarly, for equation 2, what is equation 2? 3x minus 3y equals 16. So we can write 3y is equal to 3x minus 16, and from that we can write y is equal to 3x minus 16 by 3. So now draw the table for equation 2. Now take x equal to 2, then y is equal to 3 to the 6 minus 16. That is minus 10 by 3. So minus 10 by 3, write the approximate value of minus 10 by 3. So value of minus 10 by 3 is approximately minus 3.33. So 2 comma minus 3.33 is the point. And if you take x equal to 3, then 3 is 9 minus 16, that is minus 7 by 3. And minus 7 by 3 is approximately equal to minus 2.33. So the point is 3 comma minus 2.33. Now the points on the line represented by equation 1 are 4 comma minus 4 and 5 comma minus 3. And similarly, points on the line equation 2 are 2 comma minus 3.33, 3 comma minus 2.33. So let us draw the lines for these two equations. So draw the graphs. So as usually we are writing units. Now plot the points which lies on the line 1. So first point is 4 comma minus 4, and second point is 5 comma minus 3. So draw the line through these two points. So this is the line x minus y minus 8 equals 0, which is the first one. And now let us draw the second line. So the point on second line is 2 comma minus 3.33. So it is difficult to plot the point whenever it is in decimal numbers. So we have to plot very carefully. 2 comma minus 3.33. So here we have 2 comma minus 3.33. It is approximately equal. Now after that, 3 comma minus 2.33. This one is. Now draw the line through these two points. So this is the line 3x minus 3y minus 16 equals 0, which is given as equation 2. So here we can observe that these two lines are parallel to each other. So the given equations has no solutions because there is no common point for these two lines. Okay. So the given equations has no solution. Now take the next one. 2x plus y minus 6 equals 0, 4x minus 2y minus 4 equals 0. So here I am presenting the problem without explanation. So try to understand yourself. If possible, solve yourself. If you are unable to solve, then only watch the problem, solution of the problem. Okay. So the given equations are consistent here because a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2. So that we are drawing the tables for both the equations. So we found the points on both the lines. So all the problems are same. That's why I am not explaining here. So this is the first line, and similarly this one is the second line, and these two lines are intersecting at 2 comma 2. So solution of given equations is x equal to 2 and y is equal to 2. Okay. So take the next one. So here also same problem. So again I am not explaining here. Here also a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2. That's why we need to go for c1 by c2. But a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 and not equal to c1 by c2. So here the table for the equation 1. The points on the line equation 1 are 1 comma 0 and 3 comma 2. And here also we have in decimals. So whenever the points are in decimals, it becomes difficult to plot the points on the graph paper. So the graphical method is not suitable for every problem. That's why. So after this exercise, we solve the linear equations in two variables using algebraic method. So the two equations are, two lines are parallel to each other, so that given equation has no solution. Okay students, so this is the end of the second bit. Now take the third problem. So this is the third problem. Neha went to a sale to purchase some pants and skirts. When her friend asked her how many of each she had bought, she answered, "The number of skirts are to less than twice the number of pants purchased, and the number of skirts is 4 less than the 4 times the number of pants purchased. Help her friend to find how many pants and skirts Neha bought." So here Neha answered to her friend logically, and she answered that the number of skirts are to less than twice the number of pants, and also the number of skirts is 4 less than 4 times the number of pants. So here we need to find the number of pants and skirts that Neha bought. Okay, so let's solve it. So whenever we don't know the quantities, we take them as x and y. So first, let the number of pants purchased be Neha be x, and number of skirts purchased be y. And I am taking the number of pants purchased by Neha as x and the number of skirts purchased as y. Here, from the given condition, which equation can we write? So it is given that the number of skirts, that is y, are 2 less than twice the number of pants. What is twice the number of pants? Twice the number of, as the number of pants is x, then twice the number of pants is 2x. And it is given that the number of skirts are 2 less than twice the number of pants. What is 2 less than twice the number of pants? 2 less than 2x, that is 2x minus 2. So here the number of skirts, that is y, is equal to 2 less than twice the number of pants, that is 2x minus 2. So we can write the first equation as y is equal to 2x minus 2, where the y is the number of skirts, which is equal to 2 less than twice the number of pants, that is 2x minus 2. So take this as equation 1. And in second case, what is he told? The number of skirts is 4 less than 4 times the number of pants purchased. Again, the number of skirts, that is y, is equal to 4 less than 4 times the number of pants purchased. What is 4 times the number of pants? 4 times the number of pants is as the number of pants is x, then 4 times the number of pants is 4x. And it is given that skirts is 4 less than 4 times the number of pants. What is 4 less than 4 times the number of pants? That is 4 less than 4x. That is 4x minus 4. So again the number of skirts y is equal to 4x minus 4. So take it as equation 2. Now we have to solve these two equations. So no need to write it in standard form, because while solving graphically we need to change them as y is equal to. So that's why I am not writing the equations in standard form. Now let us draw the table for equation 1. So table is x, y is equal to 2x minus 2, x comma y. And if you take x equal to 2, then y is equal to 2 to the 4 minus 2 is 2. Point is 2 comma 2. And also if you take 3, y is equal to 2, 3 is 6 minus 2 is equal to 4. So the point is 3 comma 4. And similarly find the points which lies on the equation 2. Now take x equal to 0. Then y is equal to 0 minus 4 is minus 4. And the point is 0 comma minus 4. And if you take x equal to 2, then 4 to the 8 minus 4. 8 minus 4 is 4. So the point is 2 comma 4. Now the points on the line represented by equation 1 are 2 comma 2 and 3 comma 4. And similarly on the line 2 are 0 comma minus 4 and 2 comma 4. Now let us solve these two lines graphically. Okay, now take the graph paper, draw the x-axis as well as y-axis and the units, and then write the scale. And scale I am taking x-axis equal 1 centimeter equal 1 unit, and also y-axis 1 centimeter equal 1 unit. Now plot the points which lies on the line represented by equation 1. The first one is 2 comma 2, second one is 3 comma 4, and draw the line through these two points. And this is the line, y is equal to 2x minus 2. And now take the points which lies on the line represented by equation 2. The first one is 0 comma minus 4. We know 0 comma minus 4 lies on y-axis. And second one is 2 comma 4. So this one is 2 comma 4. And now join these two points. So this is the line, y is equal to 4x minus 4. So we can observe that these two lines are intersecting at 2 comma 2, sorry, 1 comma 0. Okay, these two lines are intersecting at 1 comma 0. So the solutions of given equation, solution of the equations we have written are x equal to 1, y equal to 0. What is x here? Number of pants purchased by Neha is x equal to 1, and the number of skirts purchased by Neha is y equal to 0. That is, the number of pants is 1, number of skirts is 0. That is, she doesn't bought any skirts from the sale. Okay. So in this type of problems, it is very important to write the equations. So while writing the equations, that following given conditions very carefully. So after writing the equations, we can solve them graphically as usually. Okay students, so that's all for today, and in next class we shall complete the exercise 4.1. until then, see you, bye.